G'day, my name's Tim. I'm the Partnerships Manager for SmartShift at Amber Electric. And my role is to work with our different battery and device suppliers and different installers and other partners to help build SmartShift into the best, smartest automated demand response program that we can. I've worked for Amber for almost a year and I've been a customer for almost that long also. At home, I have a 13 kilowatt solar system, a solar edge inverter, and 20 kilowatt hours of battery storage. I also have an EV, and I try and optimize them in line with Amber's wholesale pricing the best I can.
Welcome to the Amber app. Today, I'm going to talk through setting up SmartShift and how you might use some of the controls available to you. Let's get into it. The first page, you'll see the live price. And if you swipe to the right, you'll see the live solar feed-in price. This changes regularly and is balanced out every 30 minutes. You'll see a forecast down the bottom, as well as a history. Using this, you can find cheap times to run appliances, charge your battery, or discharge manually. The devices tab. This is unique to battery owners. What we see here on this screen is the plan. The battery percentage is 97%, current energy price is 19 cents, and the renewable percentage in my area is 90%. Below this, we see a forecast. The house load, also known as usage, which is in blue. The solar's in yellow. The price is in purple. And the battery plan is in green. As you can see, my battery is pretty much full. Solar generation is expected to be around 4 kilowatts at present. As you can see, this evening, when the price hits around 40 cents per kilowatt hour, my battery plan is to discharge a certain amount in order to capture some of that high feed-in tariff for me. The amount that it discharges and whether it does so at all is affected by your battery energy, how big's your battery, and how much of your battery is going to be needed for your estimated usage this evening. As you can see, I'm not expected to use all that much energy this evening. So the battery is going to discharge a bit, and then I'll be back to self-consumption mode, the standard setting for all batteries. You can toggle the solar and usage forecast on and off by pressing the yellow button. In terms of setting yourself up on SmartShift when you first get started, the SmartShift settings click, and that will take you to a couple of different options. The first one, SmartShift automation. I leave this on. This is the smarts behind SmartShift. This is the battery being optimized for you, taking into account your usage, your expected solar production, and your battery in order to make that plan we saw on the previous screen. Without this on, you won't capture any of the high feed-in tariffs of an evening when your battery could be discharging to make you money from the wholesale market. In terms of setting a strategy, you've got two options: Earnings Optimizer and Battery Booster. Earnings Optimizer is more active. It will try and capture all the financial benefit it can and has a 10 cent per kilowatt hour minimum discharge price. It'll allow up to 2 cycles over the next 24 hours. Don't worry, this doesn't mean it will always cycle your battery twice every day. It just allows it to charge up when prices are low and discharge to capture price spike. I'd recommend staying in Earnings Optimizer while you get to know SmartShift and how it's going to behave with your battery. It's also good for those with a smaller battery than their household usage requires, because it enables them to top up overnight when it sees a cheap window of opportunity, as well as capture that earnings when it sees higher prices. Battery Booster is a little less active. It sort of sits in the background and is ready to capture any of those really high price spikes. It'll top you up from grid, but it'll only allow 1 cycle per day at a maximum. Set this if you're happy with how your battery operates normally and just want to capture those higher evening prices. Personally, I leave my battery in Earnings Optimizer most of the time. I don't want to miss out on any earnings potential, and I really like that it tops up my battery from cheap overnight energy if my solar is insufficient during the day. Automated solar curtailment. If your battery and solar system is capable of solar curtailment, this is good. What this means is if the feed-in tariff drops below zero, your solar and battery system will make only the amount of power that's needed for your home and minimize or cut off export completely so as not to penalize you for feeding into the grid. I always leave this on unless I'm charging an EV, in which case I turn it off. You can learn more about it in the link below. Syncing your minimum reserve level. This sets how much battery you have apportioned to SmartShift, and you can change it at any time. SmartShift will always leave 20% in your battery for your usage at all times. As you can see, my minimum reserve level is 0%. This does not override the default 20% minimum that SmartShift will never touch and leaves left for your use. Personally, I always keep mine low at 0 to 20%. Because I don't want to miss out on any earnings from an expected or unexpected price spike. Times that you might change this include stormy weather. If you think that there's a chance of a blackout in your area, you can click Sync Minimum Reserve Level and adjust it to something you're comfortable with. Let's set 30%. Done. Let's go back to the previous screen. It tells me what I'm doing right now. I'm selling energy. So my battery is nearly full, therefore my solar system is exporting the balance. Let's see what that looks like right now. If you swipe to the left, you can see the live screen. I've made $1.70 today, almost. This is made up of export earnings minus import costs. Each of the tiles expands, so you can look more deeply into where your earnings have come from. The solar expands, and you can see where it's gone. Today I've made 21.5 kilowatt hours, 2.3 kilowatt hours has gone to the house, 3.5 kilowatt hours has gone to the battery, and 15.7 kilowatt hours has gone to the grid. What do we see on the live screen? Well, current solar production is 11.1 kilowatts of my system. Awesome. Of that, my house is using 1.3 kilowatts. I've got 9.1 kilowatts going to the grid and 0.8 kilowatts going to the batteries. Let's check out the usage tab. What we see here is a summary of the last month. As you can see, in the last 29 days, I am $140.15 in credit. In that time, I've used 53 kilowatt hours from the grid, and on average, I've used 91% renewable energy. Yesterday was Sunday. I used 1.4 kilowatt hours from the grid and exported 20.78 kilowatt hours to the grid. You swipe up a bit, you can see the history. Yesterday's usage put me $1.19 in credit. I exported 20.78 kilowatt hours for $1.51 earnings. You can also see the history. You can tell that curtailment was happening because in the middle of the day at around 12:30, there wasn't any export when you'd expect to see some. And then you can tell of an evening, I exported between around 6 and 8 o'clock to the grid. You can also see the price. And the reason I exported to the grid was because the price was highest during that window. You can break it down into general usage and solar, have a look at your average solar export price, as well as the CO2 displaced. Some days you earn a little, and some days you earn a lot. That's the wholesale market for you. The control functions. In the devices tab, on the plan screen, you'll have a big button to control my battery. You press charge, it'll allow you to select for how long you wish to charge your battery. 30 minutes. Start charge. Now, my home usage will be covered by both solar power on the roof, 3.8 kilowatts, and any usage above 3.8 kilowatts will come from the grid. At the same time, my battery is going to start getting charged at the full 5 kilowatts that it can. If you check in a few minutes after you've pressed the charge button, you'll see the live screen would have changed. Right now, my solar is making 10.8 kilowatts and I'm bringing in 4 kilowatts from the grid. 9.8 kilowatts is going to the home and the battery is being charged at 5. Had I not pressed charge from grid, then the 9.8 kilowatts would be being used from the solar and I'd only have 1 kilowatt to charge my battery. Because the price is so low, in fact, negative right now, it's a strong incentive for me to use from the grid, hence I press the charge button and up my usage within the home. Dispatch energy.
I might use this if I think I'm faster than SmartShift at capturing a price spike. The preserve battery function. This will maintain the battery at its current state of charge. Right now, that's 76%. The battery will neither charge nor discharge. Solar will cover the usage within the home, and if there's excess, the balance will be exported. If there's not excess, if solar is only covering, say, 3 kilowatts and the home usage is 5, well then the balance is going to come from the grid.
If we check out the bills tab, we can see a history of my bills. SmartShift has me in credit. Lovely. In the settings tab, you can refer some friends and get $30 off, both of you. I can turn on green grid notifications as well as custom price notifications. Personally, I have custom price notifications at $1 per kilowatt hour. Green grid notifications are handy if you're looking for the cheapest window. Often, low price corresponds with a green grid, and this can be a good trigger to remind you to pop on the washing, heat the house, or do some cooking. I keep my notifications as app only because I'm responsive enough to that.